You welcome back, please. Sorry for the interruption. It's a network issue. Be rectified. All right. We are talking about examples of natural polymers, proteins, cellulose, starch, and many more. I repeat, examples of natural polymers, proteins, cellulose, starch, and many more, etc. Two, semi-synthetic polymers. These are polymers obtained by simple chemical treatment of natural polymers to change their physical properties. I repeat, we have natural polymers, semi-synthetic polymers, and synthetic polymers. The natural ones are of plant and animals origin, example, proteins, cellulose, starch, etc. Then semi-synthetic polymers, the polymers obtained from simple chemical treatment of natural polymer to change their physical properties, like starch. That is good. Oh, Timothy, sorry. Let me go back. I should go back?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Semi-synthetic polymer. Okay, yeah. You can see the page now. You might not need definition, just examples of natural polymers, proteins, cellulose, starch, examples of semi-synthetic polymers, e.g. starch. But remember, semi-synthetic polymers are obtained by simple chemical of natural polymers, like what? Starch. If you treat starch, then you will have it, semi-synthetic polymer. Gotten from plants and animals. As you know now.
That means it's processed starch.
Correct. Yeah, the process is to obtain the synthetic polymer. You did not process starch to get the natural polymer again, but you will rather have a synthetic polymer. Okay, synthetic polymers. Example. Let me explain this. The polymers obtained by polymerization of simple chemical molecules in the laboratory or synthetic polymers. Example: nylon, polyethylene, polystyrene, synthetic rubber, e.g., that is polyvinyl chloride, then Teflon, many more. Synthetic polymers are the types obtained by polymerization of simple chemical molecules in laboratory, which are synthetic polymers, example, nylon, polyethylene, polystyrene, synthetic rubber, PVC, Teflon, butadiene is a good example. All right, look at the structure. We have polymers, natural and synthetic. Remember, semi-synthetic is not a major type, but it is gotten or obtained when you treat the natural polymer, example starch, then you can have a synthetic one. The major category is of, now, the natural, the synthetic. Under natural, we have the functional and the structural. Functional, we have DNA in our blood, RNA, and globular proteins. Then under structure, or structural, we have fibers, and gels, and rubbers. Then under fibers, you have cellulose, silk, and wool. Cellulose, silk, wool. Then under gels and rubbers, you have agar, gelatin. Then under synthetic, you have fibers, polyesters, nylon, acrylic. Remember, polyester is used for production of a lot of respirators. You understand? Then we have the plastic. Under plastic, we have polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, PVC, then and backlights. Then under this synthetic, we have rubbers. Then 614 polyisoprene. 614 polyisoprene. By the time you get the note, you saw the structure, the subclassification under the metal classification, which is natural and synthetic. Natural and synthetic is a metal classification. Then under each of them, you have the functional, the DNA, RNA, you have the structural fibers, cellulose, wool, and gels, and rubber. Under this, you have agar, gelatin. Under synthetic, you have fibers. Under fibers are polyester, nylon, acrylic. Then you have plastic. Under that, you have polyethylene. Then polyvinyl chloride, the polystyrene, and backlight. Then we have rubbers. Under rubber, we have is not for polyisoprene. This is the subclassification under the major classification. In your personal or private study, please, you can study more about this classification. Now, let's talk about properties of polymers. Properties of polymers. Now, practically every plastic around us, every polymers around us is made up of some type of plastic. Some utensils and some gadgets around us and some appliances, they are made up of plastic. Then, the following factors have made our present plastic age possible. Number one, we have plastic. That is under properties of plastic. Plastic are properties which made them suitable for many purposes. Plastic are strong but light, inert to air. That is, they are resistant to air. Plastics are resistant to air. They are resistant to water and other chemical attacks. They are also resistant to fungal and bacterial attack. That is why they use some of them as a storage. And good insulators of head or overhead electricity. Properties of polymers. Now, in summary, properties of polymers. In summary, number one, plastic are tough. They are resistant to air, resistant to water, and fungal and bacterial attacks. And some are resistant to chemical attack. Some are used as good insulator for the passage of electricity. Then property number two, plastic can be tailor-made to our exact requirements. Plastic can be tailor-made to our exact requirements. They can be made into hard, rigid blocks, thin, flexible sheets, fibers that can be made into ropes and fabrics and very light foams. Polystyrene, a clear, transparent plastic which is hard to break. That is, you can easily flake to break. When a couple with forming agent is blown into the polystyrene, it expands in volume. Polystyrene is the result of this kind of expansion that occurs when you blow air into some of the plastic. And a good example of plastic that behave like that is polystyrene. It is transparent, very clear. Then they use it as a storage of some of drugs in pharmaceutical industries. Then look at Perspex. Perspex is a strong, hard, transparent thermoplastic with a glossy surface. Then number five, nylon. Nylon have very high tensile strength, which makes it suitable for synthetic fiber. Then tarylene. Tarylene is soft and is capable of retaining an almost permanent grease. Then these are the properties of polymers. Properties of polymers. All right, let's look at questions. We have some classwork here for you. Define the term polymerization. Two, what is synthetic polymer? Three, name two types of polymerization. And four, enumerate five uses of polymer. Enumerate five uses of polymer. Now, let me ask Samuel to tell us the definition of polymerization. Samuel, what is polymerization?
Sir, polymerization Polymerization is the coming together of two simple molecules to form a larger molecule.
That is very good. The smaller unit are called what?
Monomers.
That is very good. What is synthetic polymer? Timothy, please.
Sir,
synthetic polymer.
The fiber.
The polymer.
Yes.
Sir?
What is synthetic polymer?
The polymer is made of simple characteristics of natural.
God bless you. Alexander, name two types of polymerization that you know. Number one.
Addition polymerization.
Number two. Condensation polymerization. Use of polymer. Because of time, I'm keeping the use of polymer. You understand? So you read it on your own.
Yes.
Any question? Is there on the slide, but I did not display it because of time. Use of polymer. You understand? That slide follows the property of polymers. Then you read it. In fact, even in the presence of this class, I do explain some of the points that reflect the uses of polymers. You understand? Like PVC, I explain the uses. Then polyethylene, I explain the uses. So let me give you assignments. Look at the assignments displayed on the slide here. Just screenshot it so that you can solve the assignment I sent to me through my email address on the first page, obodomaju@gmail.com. Now, number one, briefly describe how the following polymers are formed. PVC, II, polypropene. Name the two classes of polymer. Name the two classes of polymer, II. Then number two, differentiate between natural and synthetic polymers. Number three, state the properties which is common to compounds that can be easily polymerized. So now I'll come to an end of the class. If you have any question, you can send it to me through the email or the WhatsApp. Now remember, my email address is on the first page. You can solve this assignment and send to me. All right. Let us pray in Jesus' mighty name. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the success of this class. May you help my students to understand as they read their books, particularly this very topic that we have treated. God, give them retentive memory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. See you next time.